again, Nomi. Nomi. Okay, we'll be here for this. We'll take a seat. Yeah. Just, when we come to the center, we're all equals. Right? We will respect everyone, respect each other. I've got my training partner and my coach here from Brisbane. Going to help us with a few things. Who here is ready to receive some guidance? Oh, two. As you can see, he's led a lot now. I remember I used to slap him around 10 years ago. What a change. But it's because he'll tell his story, okay? Nobody's bigger than anyone. I think I can dominate anyone. In the cage I can too, but as you can see, different level. Okay? So yeah, I'll pass in to Coach Compton and Ellie. And obviously you guys have been doing stuff with Mick. Well, Mick's a really good person in this town that obviously he was one of the pioneers in the humble person ever meet. Treat the butt into the cage if you bite. That's what I want you guys to do. Be a person that be good outside. They want to fight, come fight here, or in the boxing ring. That's when your life will switch. Okay? And I'll leave it to the Coach Compton and Elliot to do the introduction. You want to do some other?
Yeah.
Okay, you guys get to see some quick pad session, see how to prepare for fights. Choices, but he's always come back. So, you know, the path that he chose, eventually,
was, this is what we're going to do, okay? That's what you want. Sort yourself out, get straight, what do you do? Well, what's it, what does it entail? It entails, stop drinking, stop going out till 3 in the morning, stop getting in fights, and all this other nonsense that, you know, it's easy to slip into. It's your decision, which way you're going to go. So, yeah, diet has to make way. The responsibility to me, this trainer, to the gym, to all his training partners, to the people who pay money to come and see him, to turn up on weight, in shape, not been drinking, not eating well. All these things come to make what he is. And he'll explain to you in a minute. The path, to say, sometimes it's a rocky one. But you have to make that decision to be aware of it. It's a choice every time. Go over this way, go over that way. Sometimes it's hard, but you have to make that decision. So hopefully, if you have listened to what he's going to say, you may learn something. Maybe see a different perspective on things. You know, it's not, nothing's overnight. There's no overnight success. It's hard work and dedication. And if you have the discipline to do that, you can achieve anything. Any one of you. Any one of you. He's no different than any one of us. We've all been in trouble. We've all led a different life. But it's up to you, coach, where you go from here. Yep. That'll be Elliot. Thanks, guys.
I'll just quickly about respect that we have a few words before we do the game.
You want to get into that side?
Oh, no, just go.
What, not too dangerous in
there? You can stand on the, oh yeah, shoes off, see everybody's.
I know the rules.
Sorry, sir.
That's still quiet, mate.
Hey guys, thanks very much for coming. I'd like to just quickly support the good work that Arnold's doing, guys. And also Vic. As I was listening to those words just then, it's so important. We've all made probably choices, but it's where to from here. Whether you go along, there's two lines, right? I want to be part of the public, part of the team, or you want to be on the opposition. If you want to be on the opposition, you want to rob, steal, do drugs, all that, well, you meet guys like us. You know, you go to jail, do that fine, and that's the circle you get in. But if you want to make a change in your lives, you come along and do this. This starts the change. It might only be little to some of you, but trust me, it makes a huge change. Look at these guys here, listen to their stories. You've all been where you are today. But you've all got individual different stories, haven't you? You know, backgrounds. Mum's left, dad's left, brothers are left, fights at home, drugs, alcohol, women. Don't talk about women. So we've all been there, but it's where to from here. So if we can make one of you change where you are from today onwards, it's a huge success. I'd like to hope that you all come on board. Okay? You know, the future's in your hands, but this is the start coming along. Places with like Arnold and Nick to this gets you back on track. If you feel lost, you feel lonely, you feel like you've lost your way, come to the gym. Start getting integrated with this. You know, you'll start feeling better about yourselves, you start looking better, and you're not doing the stuff that you wanted to do in the past. So really, it's all up to you. You're all young men. Not boys, you're young men who make these decisions. You know, in a couple of years' time, for most of you, you'll be driving cars, looking for jobs, chasing chicks. Okay? Everything we've done, when we made choices, we got old, we made choices, and we changed our direction. Okay? You guys can do it too. It's pretty easy. But it's all up to here. It's whether you want to make the changes. Okay? So I really encourage you to keep up. You know, now that you're here, please take it on board. Listen to the advice that these guys are giving you. These two men here. If you don't listen to me, at least take on board what they're saying. Okay? They've done the hard yards. But thanks very much, Alan.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
I'll get Elliot on the podium now. He will tell you your side of the story. And there's some part I was there, he was there looking at. And I've seen where he's come, okay? So you don't get all this by sitting by the road watching and playing and doing. So yeah, Elliot.
Hey guys, as you've worked out by now, Elliot
I'm a professional athlete, professional fighter, but a bubble down, I'm a martial artist. As I said, my brother said, I've got all this list of accomplishments, and these are cool, you know, they hang on my waist, and they look cool in pictures, but they're an accessory. What got me this is the way of life that I live. I want you guys to know that today, I want to talk with you guys, I don't want to talk to you. You know, I'm not here to lecture you guys, I'm not here to teach you. I just want to share my story with you guys, hear some of your experiences, and explain how I went from living a life so far off the rails that I'm on now, to how I got to where I am. So, basically, long story short, I started training martial arts at a young age when I lost my father, Steve. I was 5 years old. How long have you guys been training? Yeah, you don't train, you don't? Okay, that's cool. How long have you been interested in training? Any of you interested in training? Yeah? Yeah? Cool. How long have you been interested in training? Yeah, okay, cool. How many street fights have you guys been in?
You're not getting in trouble.
Oh, I don't care. I'll tell you, man. I've been in more street fights than I have professional fights when I was your age. And I'm not proud of it, but that's what led me to the path that I'm on today. Yeah? So you take this thing that as you grow older, you look back and you say, man, this is a bit of a negative. It's a negative experience that I had, but you can turn that negative experience into a positive experience, and you can find your way in life and find, you know what, man, I enjoy fighting, so I'm going to do it in a positive environment. I'm not going to go to nightclubs or bars and drink and then fight and cause trouble. Yeah, so I started training martial arts when I was 5 years old. I trained all the way through my entire life. By the time I reached your age, how old are you guys? Between, how old are you? 18, how old are you? 16, how old are you? So the same sort of age, yeah? I hit high school, 13 years old. I started to fall into the bad traps. You know, the school I went to was rough. There's kids that were taking and selling drugs. Kids carried weapons. Kids were fighting every single day. Other gangs would come to my school and cause trouble. And it was an easy environment to fall into and live the same way of life as the people that were surrounded by me. And I'm not going to keep any secrets from you guys. I fell off the rails, I got into fights, I was hanging out in gangs, I was graffitiing on the streets, I was skateboarding and causing trouble, I was getting into fights in the playground, at the skate park, on my way home from school. Day in, day out, that's what I was doing. And then I developed this rebellious attitude where I stopped going to school. My parents would think that I was catching the bus to school every day. I wasn't catching the bus to school every day. I was going hanging out with my mates at the skate park, drinking, as I said, getting into fights and whatever else. Eventually the time came where they eventually said to me, look, you obviously don't gel well with school or whatever. And I said, no, I don't, and I'm leaving. They weren't overly impressed. And I left school and I enrolled myself in a college, School of Audio Engineering. I wanted to be the new Dr. Dre. I was dead set, man. I loved music, and I loved everything that I had going for me with music, and that was going to be my thing. But as I was still surrounded by the same people as I was when I was in school, I stopped going to my college, and I started falling again back into the same patterns that I was in. And my mate will tell you, before he became a police officer, he was a bouncer at a nightclub. He used to see me trying to sneak into each bar and get into trouble, and all the things that come with that. And I kept living this lifestyle for, I'll be honest with you guys, for a couple of years, man. My friends were drinking, taking drugs. A lot of them are in jail still. A lot of them have been in jail and now they can't make anything with their lives and they're still in that same pattern. I was fortunate because I had people like Amir, my brother, people like Mick, positive people around me, although for a long time, I rebelled against them and I thought, no way, man, I'm cool, I'm listening to rap music and I'm going to live this rap dream or whatever it was that I was chasing. These guys were always there for me and they influenced me into living a positive life, a positive mental attitude. So, from these guys always there, and, you know, despite me being off the rails, holding my hand and helping me through some of the things that I went through, I developed and I discovered this life of martial arts, you know, the sport and everything else that came with it. You know, I worked in this dead end job. I was calling sick, I was going, I'd stay in bed till midday and I'd get up and
same thing, skating, partying with my friends, causing trouble, getting into fights, getting arrested, vandalism, you know, breaking into things, doing all the things that I assume you guys have probably done the same sort of thing, am I right? Yeah? Yeah, man, I'll tell you, I keep no secrets. I'll tell you everything that I've done. I'm not proud of it, but I'm proud of who I am today. And those things that I did then made me who I am today. Because I look back at those experiences and I think, you know what, man? No way, I'm not going to have to be proud of that again. You know, I was not proud of who I was then. You know, nothing positive can come from a negative experience, a negative way of life. You know, say for example, I steal from you. What's your favorite possession? What's the best thing you own?
Your pants,
yeah? You need those pants because you can't walk down the street with no pants, right?
Yeah.
So I come to you and I go, hey, now I'm taking the pants. And you say, okay, because there's not much you can do about it. I'm bigger than you, I'm stronger than you. So I go, yeah, cool, I'll take your pants. What is the outcome from that? Give me one positive thing for me that's going to come from that, other than the fact that I have a new pair of pants. Nothing. What's going to happen? You're going to go home and tell your friends, or you're going to go and tell your dads or your uncles, or and they're going to come looking for me. So now all of a sudden, I've got a bigger problem on my hands. Maybe you go to the police. Now the police are knocking on my door saying this guy stole from me. Doesn't help me. However, if I see you fall off your bike, I see you fall off your bike, and I say, hey man, I'll come over, can I help you up? I say, yeah, you're cool, man, yeah, sweet. Next time I fall off my bike, what's going to happen? You're going to come running over and say, hey dude, you're cool? So the way that you treat each other is important, and a life of martial arts helps you learn these ways. Does this make sense where I'm going? Yeah? So from there, I've started. Yeah, you know, I was working this dead end job, and I was falling sick, and I was battling all sorts of depression. I was really disappointed with who I was and where I was going in my life. And I mean, I was only 16 at the time. I kept doing it. And then eventually, you know, one day, I had this positive group of people around me that came to me and said, you're better than this. Same as all you guys are better than this. You know? You might not believe it now, but it's true. You are. So you fall into these ways, and these guys come to me and say, man, you gotta think about what you're doing. Think about where you were 5 years ago to where you are now, and where you're going to be in another 5 years. Yeah? So here I am, you know, all my friends are still going out doing their thing and getting into troubles and ending up in prison and everything else that came with it. I drew a line in the sand one day and I woke up. He'd come home from work and I was hungover. I was living this terrible, shitty life. I was overweight, man, you might not believe it, I was nearly 100 kilos. Right? Purely from drinking, smoking, eating rubbish food, whatever. And he came home one day and he said to me, is this really what you want to be for the rest of your life? I thought to myself, no, it's not. That afternoon, I enrolled myself in a school to become a personal trainer. Seems like a far-fetched thing to do for an 18-year-old kid by this age who's 35 kilos overweight. But I did it. Because I had this background in martial arts, and something that I was passionate about. Somebody said to me, you know what, you can make money from something that you enjoy, you can create this life for yourself. Within 12 months from that day, I lost 35 kilos, I was the owner of my own business, I had my very first professional fight in Thailand against a guy that had 250 professional fights. I met a young girl who has supported me in my endeavors, she was chasing her own goals. I surrounded myself with positive people. That girl's now my wife, 8 years later. I've now got all this list of accomplishments. I travel the world. I travel all the way across Australia, Asia, the US, Europe, doing what I love. But how did I get there? I didn't get there from going out drinking with my mates, fighting in nightclubs, stealing cars, writing my name in pen on a wall because I've got nothing better to do with my time. I took the spare time that I had and I put it in to an end goal, end result. And that's how I got to where I am today. I mean, we'll be able to tell you some stories. Tell the boys some stories that are probably sick in my voice already. Tell some stories about me that you remember from when I was your age or younger.
Yeah, obviously, I was training with Compton. He's been an inspirational coach for me.
helped me out with a lot of stuff. Wow, I'm here because of him. So he said to me one day, my coach said to me, oh, my son is just a bit, he's gone off the rails, he needs your hand, and you just keep an eye on him, and he walks around the nighttime, nightclubs and stuff, and, just doesn't get trapped in the wrong areas. So I used to see him walk around, I'll pull him into the nightclub I was waiting, and keep him there so I can keep a watch on him. If he moved, I'll slap him, you know, so. man, but you know, it's changed like that. A very, very healthy story. All of you guys can do the same thing. And that's why when I came to Harbor Bay, I mean, my brother spoke, and we dream of this center where we can help change people's life. But my life, I mean, I'm not an angel who broke out of the sky either. You know, we all got history and story. Coach Compton said the same thing, Brother Mick has got the same sort of story to tell. No one is just a golden man. We all have their stories. But what you do with that is the most important thing. You learn from mistakes. What happens when you burn your hand on the stove for the first time? If you see a flame, you burn your hand in the flame. Do you all go to touch the flame? Who touches the flame all the time, even though they're never going to burn? Tell me, who's that person? I like to slap them. Was it? No, but like, do you see a flame? Do you like touching it? You know you're gonna burn, but same thing. You keep doing the same thing, getting locked up, getting in trouble. Would you do it? No. It's obviously not making sense where he's going. Like, I've had friends who are dead now. Good fighters, but they just couldn't shake it off. The bad part of the game. All you genuinely love to change your life, right? Want to be a respectful person in life again. What about you?
Mm-hmm.
Batman. So,
yeah.
Would you like to change?
Yeah.
Well, okay.
What do you want to change then?
Yeah.
Give me three things about yourself that you would like to change. Give me anything. It could be the clothes you wear, the way you style your hair, anything. Do you smoke?
Yeah.
Would you like to quit smoking?
Eventually.
What system are you going to put in place to quit smoking? Are you just going to wake up one morning and completely stop?
Yeah,
I guess. Hard thing to do, but you can do it. I'll take my hat off to you. It's awesome, man. How about you, man? One thing you'd like to change. Result out of a professional fight one day? Yeah. What steps are you going to follow to get there? What are you doing at the moment you're going to stop helping get there? It's breaking. Yeah.
It's about consistency, right? Yeah, it's like someone said once, a black belt is simply a white belt and never give up. And I think it's pretty good. It's not necessarily just about how skillful or what opportunities you have, but you don't give up. You know, if you can apply yourself, you will get it. If it takes you 100 years longer than somebody else, if you don't quit, once you're too short, if you don't, it's too hard, which is why people quit. But you know, it's important to remember, it's not just based around skill, it's applying yourself. It's consistency in everything you do. If you consistently break the law, cause problems, and come back and haunt you. Absolutely, it will. And that will affect you. You know, I think so now. I know, speaking from experience, it'll affect you later on. If you think it's all in your past, it's all gone, it's not. It'll come back and haunt you. So it's a good idea just to. Just look for what you want and go after it, and then seek people out that can help you. Don't just decide, I'll do this on my own, it's too hard. Because quite often it is. Look at the state he was in. But, you know, if someone's offering some help and they're genuine people, put your hand out and say, okay, I need some help. And just don't give up. I won't give up being a bad guy. You want to be a bad guy because you're not, don't you? No one's born in a bad way. It's just a learning experience. If you can surround yourself with good people, same thing. That's why I was trying to quit smoking, but all your friends consistently smoke, and you continually smoke, you're not going to quit. Double hard to stop. You know, just surround yourself with people that are going to help you, and not hinder you. There's all these promises, oh, I'll give you this, we'll do that, we'll smoke this, and you'll earn money for this, and sell this. That doesn't last forever, and they're manipulating, and they're using you. You know, it's just how it is. It's just the way of life, you know? But just stand on your own 2 feet and you say, no, I'm not going to be that guy. Go to sit to the light side and ask them to help you. And it will. Invariably people will help you. Because that's what people, just saying, that's what it's about. It's about, it's not chasing people away or trying to take people to the dark side. It's the other way. Come in and train and train and train hard. Yeah, you get showered up, you get knocked around here and there, but it's good. It's healthy. And you'll find you'll be a better person in no time. You'll go home, you'll feel fitter, stronger, you'll achieve something, you'll get a grade or a belt or whatever it is. And you'll see what that means when you eventually get, not necessarily what it is, but whatever it is. Any sort of achievement, certificate of achievement is yours. You've earned it. And no one can take that away from you. And you don't, no one's going to give it to you. Right?
It can be something as simple as having your own house or finding a girlfriend or getting good grades at school. As long as you're doing it wholeheartedly, you're doing it.
Just not finishing up at the right time. You know, kept losing. Four fights in a row. People started calling you names, telling you stories like, oh, you never make it, mate, stop doing this. Look, it's not for you. And one time he had a talk for me, he goes, oh man, this guy, who is one of our trainers anyway, he said to me, oh, mate, give it up, it's not for you. It's not for you. And I said to him, I said, remember John Wayne Park? He lost 7 fights in a row. His 7th best fight. But look at him now. But he never gave up because he had the best trainer, the best support around him. He's there.
You guys have that in the center. Whether it's from a, you guys might not be interested in martial arts. Are you interested in martial arts or fighting? Mm-hmm. Oh really? You can tell you. No, I don't care. Are you interested? Yes, yes, no. Even if you're not. The guys in the gym here, you can come in and hang out with them in the kitchen and just talk to these guys. It doesn't have to be about fighting. You can talk to them about football. You can talk to them about hip hop. I'm sure guys in here listen to rap music or guys listen to heavy metal. Or you can talk to them about smoking. I'm sure people in here smoke a cigarette or two in their life. There's always someone that you can come in and talk to, regardless of anything that you're going through in your life. Because although you might seem like you're the only one that's going through it at the moment, trust me, man, we've all been there. You know, I can tell you 100 people off the top of my head who have all gone through the dark side and come out now and they're successful in all sorts of walks of life. And I can also tell you 100 people off the top of my head who decided not to. And I can tell you exactly where they all are right now. Two places. Prison and worse. So the choice is yours.
See, with Elliot, if you would have taken those negative people's word and believed in that, would you be here giving a speech and sharing his winnings with you guys? No. People would be sitting in the same place in prison, somebody giving him his lecture about how to become good. But he didn't. And that's the difference here, guys. That's the difference. There's all these stories out there, but what are you going to do? Listen to the story and see how he changes up and make something from that life. Positive stuff. You've got to learn to pick the guys that are going to be your size and in your worst time. Tell you one thing, when you do any criminal activities out there, if you break an enter or anything like that, who's left in the watch-out with you? When you're sitting in the interview room, who's there? You. And who comes to visit you? Your mom. Or your grandma. Okay, or some family member. Not your best mate who told you you're going to break in. Is that true, mate?
I can tell you right now, from my own, it's true. When I was your guys' age, you know, hang out with the boys and we'd go and cause trouble, and you know, the police would come and we thought it would be cool and run, and you get caught, and your boys get caught too, or they don't get caught. You did nothing wrong, maybe. Maybe you just would have got along for the ride. Do you think your boys are going to put their hand up and say, yeah, no, sorry, officer, that was me. He's innocent. No way, man. Trust me. I've been there a million times. They would not, man. They would run as far from you. They'll pretend that they don't even know you.
They'll bitch on you. They'll snitch on you to get out of jail.
Yeah.
It happens, man. I do. Ask my boss there. He'll tell you the same story. He's interviewed millions of people. That's what people do. There's no better person that can stand by you and hold your hand. But don't disobey them. Don't, you know, if they're saying too much, make sure listen to them. And they'll help you.
Sometimes it's hard to go to your parents. This is my father. We spent every minute of every day together. We have a business together now. You know, but when I was your age, you were my age, and I was going through trouble, it was hard for me to go to my dad and go, hey, yo, I did this last month, you know? I remember I was out and snuck into a nightclub. I was 17 years old. And this big fella, the oldest sort of guy, he must have been mid to late 20s. You know, he's there, talking big. And I thought that I was this hotshot fighter. You know, I never had a professional fight, but I trained. And I was like, man, I was a weapon. I thought, yeah, I was a bunch of teach and punk a lesson. Tables turned pretty quickly. Before I knew it, I was bringing him on my way to the hospital. You know how hard that is to do? It was very hard. You know, that's the last thing I wanted to do. So if it's not your parents, it might be Nick. It could be our Nick. It could be me. It could be any one of these role models that are around you. You don't want necessarily to go to your parents because you don't want to have to admit that you've made a mistake or you're in trouble. There's always someone you can go to and ask for help for. Even if you don't want help, just go and sit down and talk to them, you know, and say, hey, look, this is what I did last night. I don't want anyone to know.
Even if it was 3 in the morning, he'd be fast asleep.
Even if it was 3 in the morning, he'd be fast asleep. And you have to get 17 stitches in your head when you've got a job interview the next day. It's me, you know? I've been there, and trust me, I've seen it all. But it's how you deal with it, how you come out the other side.
So surround yourself with good people, guys. And listen, nobody's in my family. Okay? Come in, help yourself. Try, make sure, start coming in and enjoying the place. You see, you're a good person, man.
Okay. Do you train? Do you want to?
You train some doors sometimes.
You get into fights and... No?
Young Matthew used to train with him. He go for a while. Just had a bit of a break for a while.
Yeah.
Think about getting back into it.
Yeah.
Well, when Integrated Martial Arts Academy began nearly 15 years ago, that was one of the divisions that would become like a family. So you can see this like part of like an extended family. You can feel like really part of this. Come here. We're all about bringing out the best in ourselves, bringing out the best in each other, supporting each other, and helping to realize what true strength and courage really is. You know, it's helping each other, it's empowering each other. Asking us to change, sometimes it does, makes us feel anxious, makes us feel that fear. But know that if you come to the Integrated Academy, there's good people here that we understand and we will support you, we'll be there for you. And there's a whole journey, our whole journey of self-development waiting for you guys. And there's fun too.
It's good fun, it's not boring, it's fun, man. It's
interesting, you feel good about yourself, and it just changes your life around for the better. So every single person here, you guys are welcome to see this as part of your family. Come here whenever you want, teach a class.
Who wants to actually have a go at holding one of the chairs for the kids? Who thinks they're strong enough? Well, just have a feel of it. Nobody's going to get injured. It's just something. Who thinks they're pretty much off?
So this whole time for pitch.
Well, no, just come on. Is good man. Man. Oh, I jump in, man.
Go.
I'll hit the other one. I'll hit the one.
I mean,
you
go first. That's okay.
Is it right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The little one. Make sure I wake up, eh?
Hey, I think you're showing courage, man. You're showing courage.
Elliot.
Oh,
you're all right?
Right, you
okay, so... Coming, you're leaning through the gate.
That's going to come in pretty hard. You've got to use your racing strength.
Pushing.
Don't look over.
Pushing. That's it. Pushing. I'll brace him just in case it flies out.
Yeah, yeah.
Mate, you want to talk
to him? Can we get your ice pack ready?
Exactly.
head up.
Oh, go ahead. Hey, wait. Head up.
Stand strong with your legs.
Yeah, come on. Good one, man. Good one. This is, guys, it's not about how strong anyone
employees or anything like that. It's all about working together, trying to help each other, bring the good in everybody out, okay? Look, a lot of times people get pushed into things like, hey, let's go do this, let's break an anchor, this is bloody awesome. But why isn't anybody falling into this? Like, hey, let's pop some kicks.
Why you guys want to be able to kick like me?
Yeah.
Yeah? Not that hard. Just takes time, commitment, dedication. It doesn't even have to be every single day. It can be twice a week, three times a week. Once a week is better than no times a week. But you got to start somewhere. You can't start. You think that the day I decided that I was going to clean my life up and I was going to go, you know what, I'm going to be four-time CMC middleweight champion, two-time South Pacific champion, Australian champion, three-time state champion, all in 8 years. No. My first goal, if I wanted to lose 35 kilos, didn't even start at 35, I wanted to lose a few kilos. I wanted to get in shape, I wanted to get fit, I wanted to start my own business. Before I knew it, I had a few fights, and then bang, my first state title shot came on. And then my second one, and my third one, and then Australian title, South Pacific, four times world champion, four times cage Muay Thai champion. Now I travel to Asia and Europe, I spent time in the US, I've done it all. But it didn't start, I didn't just start from the day I decided to start chasing that dream. It starts with small steps. And for you guys, a small step might be just coming to the gym for the first time, just hanging out. Not even learning to kick, just hanging out. Yeah, right, you'll never be a fighter. You smoke 10 packets of cigarettes a week. Easy. And you go, oh, you probably got a point, man. Yeah, no, so I won't bother. No way, man. Someone says to you, you can never be a fighter, or you can never do this, because you do this. Alright, well, I'll prove you wrong. You just watch. But you got to surround yourself with the people that go, oh, you know, I want to be four times cage more dry champion. You want to surround yourself with someone like Mick that goes, yeah, cool, let's get to work. We've got to start small, but we can get there. Might take you 10 years, might take you 20 years, might take you 2 weeks. Who knows? But you've got to start that journey. You've got to trust in that journey, not focus on the destination. You've got to embrace the ride the whole way.
Yeah, well, Elliot's brought some autograph bowlers and stuff for you guys. It was nice enough to do that. And also, he's got a video clip of his highlights of his fights that he can show. Like, Elliot, not many, do you guys know Kickboxer? The movie? Has anybody seen Kickboxer movie? Mm-hmm. Okay, you can watch it. Anyway, it's an invitation only to fight this fighting for the king. I would love to fight him there, but I never heard that before. So I decided to go to a different gym. But Elliot kept on his journey and believed in himself and kept going in that direction, what he wanted to become. He got invited to come and fight in this holy grail of Muay Thai. Every fighter in the world who does Muay Thai would love to fight, but if no one gets that opportunity, maybe a handful can say, yes, I got it. Remember that, I got it. I think John Wayne Park got it, and a few other others got it. Eric was the other one that got it. Now, this is not just somebody, I have one. See, there's a difference. There's world champions, and there's Muay Thai champions, Thai champions. It's two different. You can be a world champion, lose every fight in Thailand, because they're different level. They're just different. So, Elliot got invited to come and fight in this prestige place where only very limited Westerners have ever been allowed to fight. And he went in there and knocked the tiger out with the elbow. And that's something. It's like getting a tiger out there and spitting on the face in front of the whole thing. It's like that. They take it that way. And he did that. Why he was able to do it and stand tall? Because he believed in his father, believed in his training, believed in himself, and put in 120%, didn't listen to all this bullshit, and people were trying to put him in a different direction. He followed it. His father put him in front of people that half the size guys he was scared to fight with, and he go in the cage or in the ring and fought it, never asked a question. He was still very young, and people were like doubting him. He never listened to that because
they were coming in up to me in the dressing room, my hands and I stretched them all out, and they come over and go, oh, and then another person would come over and they'd be pointing at you and laughing and talking and high and betting against you and laughing, yeah, making you feel like you're this big. You know, it was the most intimidating thing that I've ever had. And you walk out to fight, and, you know, when you fight in Australia or other big Western show, there's a big runway with big flashing lights and it's real glitz and glamour. Wellbeing stadium, you sit next to the ring and you watch the fight previous to yours. The fight previous to mine, the guy got knocked out in the second round with this disgusting head kick that was the most horrifying thing that I've ever seen. And I looked into the crowd, there's 10,000 screaming Thais, gambling and screaming at you and whatever else, and you think, oh man, and Tony, it was the easiest time for me then to say, you know what, I'm just going to just tap him out and leave him. But I didn't. I had to trust in the people around me, the people that set me on my journey and encouraged me. And I stepped in that ring and I fought for 3 rounds. I knocked him out in the third round with a spinning elbow. And you know what? Once that happened, everybody in that stadium wanted to be my best friend. And we had to get escorted from the ring to where I had to do a TV interview by the Thai Army security there with their machine guns, because everybody was trying to stop us for pictures and autographs and grabbing at me. We had to get escorted just to do this interview. But I made that choice there and then. I could cut and run, or I could see it through. And I saw it through, and it set me to where I am now.
It's like, I don't think you guys understand what it is. It's like, I had a smaller version of that when I went to Sydney and fought in a Serbian club against a Serbian guy. Everybody in the club was Serbian, in the Serbian club. So everybody was Serbian, and I'm the only person that's around fighting as a Serbian guy for the main title. And as you can see, there was no good word coming out of English mouth. But that was just a small scam. He was in their country, fighting in the top stadium, surrounded by all the Thais. Can you feel?
Live on TV.
And live on TV. And only person that's on the corner is your dad and the other cornerman, and no one else cheering for you.
And remember, it is their national sport.
Yeah.
It's not like it is here, like a bit of a, you know, an alternative sport where it's got a small viewing percentage. If you watch the Saturday night Wellbeing TV show in Thailand, it's like watching the Wallabies play, or like watching the Broncos play, or the Socceroos. That is the biggest stadium that appeals to the biggest market of the biggest sport in their country.
And actually in South Asia, about close to 1 billion people watch that show. So you can think 1 billion people. But like, you know, that thing didn't faze him. And it's not about comparing anything here. It's not about saying that, oh, he's God and all that. What it is, listen to his story. Take something.
In the same position as you guys. I remember being your age and having the same thing when people came and tried to talk to me. Pretty much the same situation as this. You come in and say, you can do this. And man, I can see some of the attitudes in you guys. You're not really interested, and I remember feeling exactly the same, but trust me, one little thought of today that will stick with you, and eventually the time will come where you'll step up and go, oh, remember that meathead that came to the gym covered in tattoos and facial scars and he said that I could make something of myself? I think he might have actually been right, because I found this thing that I love, and you know, it's not everybody's cup of tea, but I do it pretty good, and I'm going to stick with it, and I'm not going to hang out with you. Trouble that I'm hanging out with, I'm just going to just see where it gets me. And that's where your path will start. But you got to make that decision, you got to recognize that. It might be the smallest thing that one of us has said today, or it might have been something that your teacher said to you 5 years ago, or a cop said to you one night when he pulled you up for drinking on the street, or whatever it is, and you go, hang on a minute, man. A light just came on, and that makes sense. But you got to find that light within yourself.
What we have telling our story, Elliot's telling his story. The reason he's achieved all that is because he sacrificed. He didn't take corners, he didn't make excuses. If his leg was broken, he was out training using his hands. His dad would not leave him not to train. If he get knocked out, his dad will say, your fault, you didn't keep your hand up.
Before, maybe 18 months ago, early in the second round, got broke his cheekbone. And come back to the corner and said, is there something sticking out of my face? Cut, yeah. It's okay, it's okay, right, keep going. Is there something sticking out? There's nothing sticking out of your face. Throw it back at me. Come back, split here, rip through here. 18 stitches, a broken cheekbone. Look at that, finished the fight. I got a picture of him somewhere in the last round. Got knocked down, the guy tapped him on the jaw, and he just went, fell down. Looked at the corner and I'm here looking at me. Somebody snapped it, it's covered in blood, completely covered. And the ref went to work, the doctor wanted to wave it off. And the ref, Brian Murphy, he said, no, he doesn't deserve that. Do you want to go on? He said, yes. I said, you can't win, it doesn't matter. I want to finish the fight there. Here we go. Right? Up to you. Clever. This wiped him, the doctor sat back down, and he finished the fight. We took him to the hospital. CT scan. This was pushed in. A bite was sticking this way, but not out through the skin, but this way. You can imagine through here. Every time you touch, you can get him on this. Split the beginning here. Split here. You can see a skull on this one. This was ripped open. But just, I don't want to stop. I don't want to give up. That's the only difference. And at the end of it, Stan, you got a bigger stand elevation than the guy that did it to. But you know what I mean? It's like, just, it's that, I don't want to give up. I know what it takes, and I'm not going to give up. And it's okay to be scared. It's okay to be weak or whatever. Because, you know, as I tell people, without fear, you wouldn't know courage. If you're never scared of anything, you don't understand what courage is. Because you don't understand about being scared. If you're scared of something, you still face it. That's courage. If you're weak, it shows strength by still going ahead and doing something. So you need this to be able to see this one. It's not a weakness. You need this to be able to hit this one. As long as you address it that way, you can achieve it. Honestly. I know it sounds like we're waffling on here. But, oh yeah, I've heard this before. But I'm just bringing my boy here to show you what we did. You should have been. And I just really hope that some of you guys come along and learn this path. Just go on a different path than your own. Because it will work. Honestly, just keep flattening back no matter what. And you will get knockbacks. You get back up, keep going, and you will get there. 100% you get there. Only
give up
when you stop, that's
when
you're
done. Swinging. Who here will get a bust of face and get keep going? That bomb popping out of his head.
That's what you're going to tap into. If you believe that, tap into that.
Mine, yes. It's all about mine. Okay? You can do it. Everybody has got it. They're all the same, man.
Everybody's got a broken face. It's not me and Mitchie that's got a broken face. This could be on my job. No, mate. One's job, no mate. Just keep going. You'll get there. You know, being pushed back and knocked back, I want to join this gym, I want to join that, I want to learn this. Someone says, no mate, I want to get somewhere else. Go around the obstacle, around the stop we go, mate. Go around it, keep going to you, find somebody who will do it. It will help you. You might think a little bit, like, I don't want to get blocked with martial arts, but you may spend 6 months here and you'll see things differently. But other things, I may be able to do this.
We've got strength and conditioning classes, and we've got either meditation and yoga, and we've got a whole heap of different things available. It doesn't just have to be fighting if you don't want to do that. You can do it all, but strength and conditioning, fighting,
more serious exercise.
Yeah,
that's it.
We'll do it on Saturdays here at 7 o'clock in the morning if anybody wants to come for a run. We'll do 45k run with Simon. Called talent and boxing. You know, factoring that you can come and do that. It's all about just putting yourself out there and doing something. Now, like, it's not all about fighting is a means. Like I said, I became a police officer. I was scared of going to uni, but with all this, inspired me to go to uni to get a degree. I was one guy was scared of uni, but I was so scared because I'm English on my best language, and you know, when I did go to like reading and writing, I had to. Get back and do it, and I was scared for nothing. I inspired myself 5 years, it took me, I finished it. Now, I'm happy that I finished my degree. You all can do it. If I can do it, man, you can do it too. You can do it too, you can do it too. And you all can do it. There's nobody small or bigger. Everybody has got something. All right, good to go, guys. Come on, guys. Come closer.
It's not very loud, so.
Are you going to come to me later? Thank you. Hi, kids, you guys want to come and quickly have a look at this? All the kids can come in. Robbie, come. Getting in the ring is just a small part of the whole journey. It takes hours and hundreds and hours and years to get there. resuscitated the Lord. Today when you wake up, you go, oh my God, my leg, I can use my leg because I haven't gone to the toilet. I'm going to get up. That's what he's trying. Even anything that I got is like that.
Like you're not saying forcing everything to turn up in the fighting game.